The results of this summer's big butterfly count are in, and huge thanks to the 95,000 of you who went out and took part. The results are much better than we feared. On average, people saw 12 individual butterflies per count, which is the highest for 4 years. Part of that increase is undoubtedly due to the Red Admiral, which had an amazing year, and lots of you reported seeing plenty of Red Admirals around. Traditionally, this butterfly is a visitor to Britain from warmer parts of Europe, but because of climate change, is now here in larger numbers and year-round. Now, you might be surprised that butterflies were recorded in better numbers this summer, because to be honest, the weather's been pretty rubbish. But actually, this has been better for our butterflies than the drought that we had in the summer of 2022. The plants are still green, the flowers are still in bloom, it's food for caterpillars, and it's nectar for our butterflies to drink to keep them going. And it's been really wonderful after a few days of damp, dreary weather to be able to get out into the sunshine and see plenty of butterflies around. And we've really enjoyed hearing your stories about where you did your count and what you saw. However, we've got to put the good news about butterflies this summer into the bigger picture. We've produced, for the first time, 13-year trends going back to the start of big butterfly count, and they present a much more depressing picture. More species have decreased in abundance than have increased since the start of big butterfly count, and these are our most common and widespread butterflies. The main reason for the decline of butterflies in the UK is the destruction of habitats. Butterflies can cope with our notoriously variable weather. They're used to that, but they need places to live. If those places have been destroyed, then no matter how much the sun shines, butterfly populations are going to go down. And that's where you come in. We're calling on you to create a wild space, a place where butterflies can live, where they can feed, shelter, and breed. Now, this can be in any outdoor place. It can be on a balcony, on a patio, in a garden, or down at the allotments, or in the school grounds. We've created an amazing new wild spaces website packed with information to help you create your wild space. And now's the perfect time to get involved. If you start planning and creating your wild space now, hopefully there'll be more butterflies for you to see during next summer's big butterfly count.